Well, hey everyone, today I want to show you how to use the Neutrik Ethercon cable connector carrier. This one particularly is called the N8mx-b. Now this is really useful in pro audio to take your regular category cables, your regular Ethernet cables, and make them more rugged and more able to be locked into things. So it's a fairly simple build, but sometimes it's still really good to see people walk through it so you see what you're getting into. And what's really nice, these are the more updated version of this connector. The old ones were a little bit more tricky. They've actually simplified these and they're really nice to work with. So this is the one that's made for pre-assembled Ethernet cables. So in this case, this one was already made previously. You don't have to terminate this after the fact. If you don't know how to make Ethernet cables, just check out my video I have made previously. So this connector carrier will work with either your standard RJ45 or your special RJ45. Now the vast majority of what I've ever worked with was just that standard RJ45, but either way this will work. So I'm just going to show you the different parts here. There's four main parts and one has kind of two different versions. So we have the bushing, the chuck. There's two versions of the boot and then the housing. To start with, you need to take your cable, and if it has a snagless boot, you'll need to remove that. So if this is a terminated cable or it's like through a wall or something like that, you'll have to grab a pair of snips and like cut that off. In my case, this other end isn't terminated, so I'm just gonna just pull it off. This can be a bit stiff, there you go. And then first thing, it's fairly simple, you can just slide the bushing over top of that, and of course it's made for pre-assemble, so it'll slide just over. Then you have to decide which of the boots you want to use. Now these ones are made for a thinner version of the cable, and these have never worked well for me, and especially if I ever use Cat 6. For Cat 5 they can work. I'm going to quickly test it on this cable. The way that works is you put it on, you clamp it over top, and then you put it around. And actually in this case, this one will work. So that's what I'm gonna use. If you use Cat 6 or thicker cables, then you'd have to use this boot here. And see, it's only in half. So what you gotta do is slide it together. This is because it's pre-assembled. And then you just gotta slide these two. You see this kind of grooves there. And on both sides, you slide that together. And that becomes your boot. I'm gonna take that apart for now. I'm going to use the other one. So this could be put on later, so that's what I'll do because it's probably going to slide around now. And then you have your chuck. You could put that on later. Quite often I put that on now just so I don't forget about it. And this will become very important in just a second. Alright, so once you have the chuck on, you've got to figure out to make sure if you have the standard or special RJ45, and that'll determine how the chuck is actually directed. One thing they say is they want you to break the tab off. And you know what, sometimes I like to reuse these cables for other purposes, so I like to keep the tab on in case I want to take it apart. And I've done a bunch of these, and the tab not being taken off has never caused a problem. So this will work just fine. So in this case, this is the way this one mounts. You just slide that tab underneath that little part there. And you'll see how it fits just on top of there. See how it sits nice and straight inside of there? That goes on that part. Should be pretty clear there. Then you gotta take the housing and then you gotta figure out how to slide it in. So you see there's a bigger opening where the tab would go. So just gotta slide that in. And that should slide in nice and gentle. That should come at least a slight bit behind the entrance there. Let me just focus that up for you. There we go. And you see how it's not sticking out past the edge. That's really actually important. So then now, all you gotta do is put together your boot assembly. So that's just is fairly simple. You just clamp that together. And then there's this little, that just clicks in, boom, boom. And then just put it all together. Slide the bushing forward, tighten that down. There you have it. Now what you'll want to do is actually try this on something that has an Ethercon female connector. And once in a while it doesn't want to sit in exactly right. So what I recommend in that case is just loosen the housing a bit, click it into your device, and then re-tighten it. and that'll make sure it's in there nice and straight. All right, so this is a fairly simple build, but I know it's nice to see it get done, and hopefully that helps you out. All right, God bless, take care.